Good morning, traders. Matt Weller here, Global Head of Research with Forex.com. Today is the 16th of September, 2024. It's a Monday, and here are going to be some of the key things that you need to know ahead of today's U.S. trading session. Now, on balance, we're seeing fairly quiet markets to start the week. That's because many major Asian markets are closed for the day, from China to Japan to South Korea. And some of those closures, as you'll see on this slide, are expected to carry over into the early part of the week as well. Chinese markets close tomorrow, South Korea the next 2 days. That's going to concentrate a lot of the volume, volatility, and market activity into the European and US sessions. And that's going to be an important dynamic to keep in mind as we move through the earlier part of this week, because it is central bank week. We see major central bank meetings from the Federal Reserve, the Bank of England, the Bank of Japan, the Norges Bank, and the PBOC all taking place in the latter half of this week. The big question, though, is what will the Federal Reserve do? Traders are split pretty evenly between expecting a 25 basis point rate cut and a 50 basis point rate cut. In fact, just in recent hours, the 50 basis point rate cut has sort of taken the perceived lead, seen as a 65% probability in markets. This after a Wall Street Journal report last week seemed to put it back on the table. Now, the key question in that regard is whether we'll have the Fed tip the scales one way or another, maybe have another such Nikki Leaks Federal Reserve preview report that could hint at what Federal Reserve policymakers are going to do. After all, the Fed does not like to surprise markets. It likes traders to know what they're going to do before they do it. And at this point, with the Fed in a blackout period, one of the few ways to do that is through trusted journalists that can get that message out. So I'll be keeping a close eye on venues such as the Wall Street Journal to see if we get some sort of clarifying report ahead of the Fed, because if we head into it with this amount of uncertainty, we're likely to see a lot of market volatility on Wednesday. Today's chart of the day is the euro versus the US dollar on a daily basis. I'm looking at this chart as a bit of a bullish flag right now, where we saw a strong move up through June, July, and August. We've seen a modest pullback heading into September here, but found support at the shallow 38.2% Fibonacci retracement near 110 even, and are now testing the top of that bearish channel or bullish flag pattern. If we can break out above that area, a move back up toward 112 or even a longer term Fib retracement closer to 113 could be in play for euro dollar. So that is today's video. Thank you for carving some time out of your day to watch. And regardless of whether you're catching us on Twitter or YouTube, please do like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and give me a follow on Twitter. We'd really appreciate your support. Thanks, and best of luck with your trading.